Okay, we're gonna start with making our root beer. We have our ginger bug. Mario, stir it and let's see if it sizzles, fizzes. Stir it good. Let's see. Let go. Do you see any bubbles?
Nope.
Yep, they're on the edge. They're right on the edge. So this is our ginger bug. This is our starter. And now we're gonna get the juice, right, man?
Yep.
Okay, now we're gonna pour our liquid from our strained sassafras roots, star anise, cardamom pods, cinnamon, peppercorns, and there's vanilla bean in there too that I steeped afterwards. We're gonna put our vanilla beans in here and I'm gonna leave them in there to get more vanilla flavor while this is fermenting. Okay, Mario's pouring the ginger bug in. He's straining the ginger out, but the ginger bug is fermented, so that's our starter. Okay. Okay, stir it up good. And the liquid has, in the pot, I reheated the liquid because I made the liquid a couple of days ago. And I put 3 cups of sugar in the pot and warmed it up this morning. And that's when I added the vanilla bean after I shut the stove off to steep.
It smells like cinnamon apple pie.
Yeah. And now Mario's gonna put a cover over it, one that can breathe, with a rubber band to avoid any dust or fruit flies if there's any left around here. Because now it's gonna ferment. It needs the active yeast in the air combined with the fermented, the ginger bug starter. And we're gonna leave it on the counter and we're gonna stir it every day until we see it bubble. Okay, we're gonna start a new ginger bug since Mario poured the old ginger bug, the whole thing, in our root beer. All it is water with some ginger, not all of it, because we're gonna put a little ginger every day. That's good. And some sugar. Maybe a tablespoon of ginger and a tablespoon of sugar.
What about a teaspoon?
You don't have to measure it, just pour it in. Just pour it in. Dump it over. Let it go. A little more. So every day, we're gonna feed a little bit more ginger, a little bit more sugar, and we're gonna stir. Right, ma'am?
Yeah.
Okay. And within a few days, this should bubble and be ready to be a new starter for some more ferments. Okay, so there's our root beer. That all we need to do now is stir it every day until the active yeast in the air ferments and gets this fizzing. Once it starts fizzing, I'm gonna put it in these bottles and cap them and let it build up gas and we'll have real natural root beer. Here's our ginger bug, started today. So, you know, within a week, it's kind of cold in my kitchen now. But what I do is, if I want this to ferment faster, I'll put it in my oven with the oven light on and it'll keep it at a steady warm temperature, but not too warm to kill off the active yeast. And then we can use this ginger bug to make new ginger ale or start any, or root beer or any kind of fermented soda that we want.